Welcome to another training session on TIA Portal. In today's session, we are going to learn how we can read an analog signal from the S7-1200 PLC and how we can scale that analog signal into some usable values. As always, before starting, I would request you guys to please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for more upcoming video tutorials. As you can see that today we have S7-1200 PLC and we have connected analog signal generator with it, and we have connected 0 to 10 volts analog output of the signal generator to the analog input channel 0 of the S7-1200 PLC. Now let's go to the TIA Portal software and see how we can make a program to read that analog signal and how we can scale the signal into some usable values. First of all, we will open the TIA Portal and create a new project in it. We can give this project any name and click on the create button. Now the project is creating, and once the project is created, we will open the PLC programming tab and create a new device in it. From the drop-down menus, we will open the CPU menu, and from the CPU menu, we will select the S7-1200 PLC 214-1H31 as we are using this CPU in our today's tutorial. This will add this CPU into our project. Next, we will go to the project view. And here we will open the PLC folder and open the device configuration. If we click on the CPU and open its properties, here we can see the analog input properties of this CPU. If you scroll it down, you can see the channel 0. This channel 0 input is coming into this input word 64. And this analog channel 0 is a voltage channel. This means that it can only read 0 to 10 volts. And right now the signal smoothing is selected to the 4 cycles. And we can change it to medium and strong as per our requirement. For today, we will keep it only the medium with 16 cycles. This will remove some ripples and noise which is disturbing our analog signal. Next, we will go to the program blocks and open the main block OB1. Next, we will open the conversion operations. We will drag and drop the NORMX function. And here we will select the double integer input, and the minimum value we will insert it as 0. And in the value input, we will insert the IW64, which is our analog input channel 0. In the maximum value, we will insert 27,648. At 0 volts input, our PLC will understand it as 0. So we have entered 0 in the minimum value. And at 10 volts, our PLC will take it as 27648 value. That's why we have entered this 27648 value in our max input. Next, for the output data type, we will select the real. And in the output, we will insert MD20. Now our NORMX function will take the analog input, which is coming into the input word IW64, and normalized it from 0 to 1 and save this normalized value into the MD20 data register. Next, we will drag and drop the SCALEX function. Input value, we will again select the real data type, and we will use same MD20 data register as a value input. We can rename the MD20 data register as a normalized value so that it is more understandable. And in the minimum value, we will insert the 0.0. Right now it is giving some error. To solve this, we have to select the output data type as real as well. Next, we will insert the max as 200.0. In the out, we will insert the MD40 data register, and we can rename this data register MD40 as a scaled value. The SCALEX function will scale the normalized value MD20 between 0.0 to 200.0 and save this scaled value into the MD40 data register. Next, we will download this project into the PLC. And once the project is downloaded, we can monitor the ladder logic. As you can see that right now the input is 0 and our normalized value is 0 and our scaled value is 0 as the input voltage is 0 volts. As you can see that now as I increase the input analog voltage, the normalized value is starting to increase. And our scale function is scaling this normalized value and this scaled value is getting saved into the MD40 data register. So this is how you can use the NORMX and SCALEX functions to read and scale an analog input. In the next video tutorial, we will learn how we can generate an analog output using S7-1200 PLC and the TIA Portal software. Before leaving, I would request you guys to please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for more upcoming video tutorials.